Good evening. On behalf of Vice President for Intercollegiate Athletics, Lon Reisman, welcome to the 2022 Tarleton Athletic Hall of Fame Induction Dinner. My name is Scott Garner, and I am honored to serve as your host for the evening. Tonight, the university will induct a group of men that comprise one of the most memorable football teams this university has ever produced. The 1986 Tarleton State Texans have left an indelible mark on the institution for which they performed. It's been 36 years since Bill Pringle's Texans donned the purple and white. And tonight, they will forever be immortalized in the annals of Tarleton's Distinguished Hall of Fame. Long before Tarleton became a four-year institution in 1961, the university was competing for championships. Joining the Texas A&M system in 1917, Tarleton athletes were not known as Texans, but Junior Aggies. In 19, became disenchanted with the name Junior Aggies and held a contest to select a new mascot. The winner would receive a whopping $5. That's how the Tarleton Plowboys came about. Some years later, in 1961, it was changed again, this time to Texans. Through all of Tarleton's rich history and well over 100 years of college athletics, only 173 individuals and teams have been so fortunate as to have been inducted into the Tarleton Athletic Hall of Fame. It's long been known that athletics is the welcome mat to a university's front door. Curb appeal is important. And when you have the type of success the 1986 Sunflower Bowl champion Tarleton Texan football team experienced, it's that type curb appeal that gets you inducted into the Hall of Fame. The 1986 Tarleton State Texan football team embodies perseverance, resiliency, and a willingness to overachieve, and all the character traits that springboard a team to. The 1986 Texans snapped an eight-year championship drought, posting nine wins with an 11-game schedule, culminating with a dramatic 40-38 Sunflower Bowl victory. The eight straight wins alone were absolutely remarkable, considering it wasn't a perfect start. But to crack the top 10 on their way to a bowl berth was something not even the most fervent Texan fan could have expected. Tonight, we celebrate the unbelievable and unforgettable run. Tarleton continues its march toward becoming the premier athletics program in the Western Athletic Conference. As we do this, we celebrate our past successes and look ahead with eager anticipation to many victories on the horizon. It's a great time to be a Texan. We'd like to take a moment to extend a warm welcome to our special guest tonight, University President Dr. James Hurley and his wife Kendall. Dr. Sherry Benn, Vice President for Diversity, Equity, and Inclusion. Jennifer Colley, Interim Vice President for Institution. Our sponsor for the evening, Tanglewood Pharmacy. Our first speaker has been leading Tarleton's competitive excellence since 2019. He's been a consistent supporter of our mission and goals as an athletic department on our quest to national recognition. Please welcome the 16th President of Tarleton State, Dr. James Hurley.
Thank you, Scott. Let me start by saying a special thanks to Sodexo, who I know they're some of those Texans are back there in the corner anxiously awaiting to feed us a good meal. And they work relentlessly on this campus. Nearly 90% of the workforce for Sodexo are our current students. And so Sodexo does an incredible job of helping our Texans afford a Tarleton degree. So if we would, let's give Sodexo a big hand and say thank you. We've had a great weekend with our 1986 football team. And I tell you, these guys are a lot of fun. A lot of fun. I don't know if I'm envious or thankful that I wasn't the president and 1986. We, Kendall and I had the luxury of hosting their football team and their spouses and families in the Trogdon House. And I will admit that's the most full we've had the Trogdon House ever, and we're thankful for it. But here's what I've noticed. These football guys, this is a football term, you outkicked your coverage, every single one of them. And we're here to celebrate the successes of our football team. But I would like for all the spouses and family members of our football inductees to stand up and allow us to say thank you for supporting these guys over the years. So all of the lovely ladies, if you'd stand up. The guys will get their due soon. And some of you, you're going to walk across the stage and you're going to sit back there and say, how in the world did he marry her? Because he's a great football player. That's how it goes. Some things never change. We are more than thankful for the foundation that this 1986 football team laid for our, in particular, the Tarleton football program that we have today. I think Coach Witness said this many times. This group in particular laid the winning championship tradition that we experience today. In the last 4 years, I think our football team is, 34-10 or 35-10. And if you think back to this team, all of the championships that we were able to win is now leading our program. The roots trace back to this team. Toughness, team, brotherhood. A lot of our coaches, that's what they recruit on, is the Tarleton brotherhood. And I wish we could bring every single recruit that Coach Witten has been recruiting for next year here this weekend to see just what family means. And so thank you for that. Thank you for sticking together. Thank you for many of you come back often. Some of you I've heard this is the first time in 10 years, 15 years that you have been back to this campus. Let's not let that happen anymore. Okay, we need you. We have a long road ahead of us as we continue our transition and as we continue to pursue FBS football. We need you. We need you to come back and support these guys. We need you to love on our football players, but not just our football team, but all of our staff. There's a great chance next year that we will surpass 16,000 students in the fall. Now, I looked up the numbers when you were here in 1986. We were roughly a little over 3,000. We were right at 3,100, a little under 3,200 students. We've came a long way. But part of that is because, again, the foundation that you laid, not only during your time here, but post. Right now, you have the incredible opportunity to tell the Tarleton story. And our institution is nationally known now. What Division I has done for us, it has elevated our profile. I've often said, and Lon's heard me say this, Lon and I met, it was within my first 5 days on the job in July of 2019, I said, Lon, we need to be a Division I institution. Tarleton has deserved to be a Division I institution for many, many years. We didn't know it would happen in our first 35 days. We overachieved a little bit there. And then once the dog caught the car, we said, now what? Right? But we knew we had this incredible foundation. Also, I want to brag on Lon Reisman and all of our coaches. And I think we have several athletic staff members in this room. So if you are a part of, Lon, I know you're going to introduce and recognize our past inductees, correct? So I will not do that. But I would like for all of our support staff, I see our academic support and athletics, I see our faculty athletic rep, I see some of our coaches. If you would stand and allow us to say thank you for your continued service of excellence to our current student athletes, thank you all so much for that. Coach Witten, I see Coach Witten. Steve Simpson. When Steve Simpson, Lon Reisman, Hanson, and John Tarleton settled this institution, they would have never thought 122 years later we would be in this room doing the amazing things that are taking place. I want to say something, though, about our current student athletes. In the history of the NCAA, that's a long time. No institution, not a single reclassifying institution, has had the wins and losses, I should say the winning percentage, that we've had across the board. Our football team has had back-to-back winning football seasons. That's unheard of. It never happens for a reclassifying institution. And all of our other sports. In fact, just this year, we captured our first WAC championship in our first 2 years. Unprecedented. Our women's tennis. And under Vice President Reisman's leadership, what I'm most proud of is that's our academic progress rate. So we traced back, I think it was 19 institutions, roughly, almost 20 institutions. Not a single institution that reclassified had a higher two-year APR rate than Tarleton State University. So that is an incredible academic feat. So not only are we winning on the field, we're winning in the classroom. And these young men and women are graduating, and they're leaving here with not only one degree, but many of our students are leaving with multiple degrees. So, Lon, I'd like for you to stand up and allow us to say thank you for your excellent leadership throughout this transition. Now, I was looking at the list, and Coach Pringle, thank you for your leadership. Thank you for your dedication throughout the years here and leading these young men. I've heard so many wonderful stories about you. I've heard so many stories about how much you cared for them, and it's not until you're out of school that you really love your coach, right? And I understand that. But I see on this list that Mike Myers is going to speak tonight. And so after the presentation of 2022 honorees, I will make my way back to the podium to clean up anything that Mike has to say. We are thankful for Mike. He's very involved here. Of course, Big Mike, we wouldn't have some of the things that we have in terms of facilities without the Myers family. Enjoy this evening. I'm so thankful for all of you being here. Please come back. Homecoming, Lon's going to talk about that. Come back often. Love on these student athletes. Continue to support this institution. And so thank you for being here, and I'll close with may you forever bleed purple.
Thank you, Dr. Hurley. Tonight's invocation will be given by an esteemed alumnus who is a member of the 2015 Hall of Fame class and a representative for Fellowship of Christian Athletes. Rodney Payne has tonight's invocation.
Let's pray. Heavenly Father, I want to come to you, Lord, just thanking you for this moment that you've given us, Heavenly Father, to honor these Hall of Fame inductees, and thank you very much for them and what they mean to this institution. I pray, Heavenly Father, that you'd continue to watch over them and protect them, and thank you for their families, Lord, and thank you for all that you do at this university. Thank you for Coach Reisman and his team as they put this banquet together, Lord, and I just pray that you'll just be with him, Lord, and bless him, and thank you for everything that you've given us. You're our creator. You're our rock. I just ask, Heavenly Father, as we go throughout this evening, that everything that's said and done will glorify you. Thank you so much for your son, Jesus. Thank you for this food. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen.
By the way, at this time, we'd like to extend a special thank you to Ed Horton and Tanglewood Pharmacy for sponsoring tonight's event. Ed, I don't know if you know this, is a native of HICO and began his practice in Kemp, Texas in 1975, and he opened Tanglewood Pharmacy, as clairvoyant as he is, in June of 1986, knowing full well what kind of team that Tarleton State was going to have back then. And we thank you for being here, and thank you for sponsoring tonight. Appreciate it very much. Thank you. The program will continue after dinner. Thank you. honors, and awards, as well as fundraising goals in his time here at Tarleton. For 30 years, he served as the head men's basketball coach, winning 654 games, the most ever by anyone in Tarleton history. Under his direction, Tarleton has flourished in nearly every sport and has made the transition to Division I athletics, joining the Western Athletic Conference. Please help us welcome Vice President for Intercollegiate Athletics, Lon Reisman.
Well, I know if you're not done eating, just keep right on eating and enjoying your barbecue tonight. And I'll make this short because I've spoke too much today to this bunch. So I do want to say a couple of things. And one of them is that I know we have a lot of our Hall of Famers here tonight that have already been. They've come from all over the country. I know that they've traveled great distances to be here. So. If you're one of the Hall of Famers, could you, all the Hall of Famers that have already been inducted, would you please stand so we can give you a round of applause, please? All the Hall of Famers. Thank you very much. It's very important, and I really want to do continue to build this. It's very important for our Hall of Famers to return. You are the legacy of this university. And it goes all the way back until when we were junior college back in the 30s and 40s and 50s. And it's so important that we have our Hall of Famers come back because it's nice to hear the history. You know, there's so much at the reception last night, at the breakfast this morning, you know, over at the Trogdon House today, at the president and the first lady's home. Just to hearing to the Hall of Famers that are being inducted tonight and listening to what happened during the seasons and their times at Tarleton, you can't replace that. You can have wins and losses on the field, but you cannot replace relationships. And your relationships are everything to your teammates, to the university, to the history that we build every day here. And so it's so important that we continue to come back and be a part of this university. So I want to encourage you, 86 Sunflower Bowl team, do not let this be the last time you come to a Tarleton Hall of Fame banquet, dinner. We need you back every year. I hope I have to move that out of here. I'm hoping one day that I can, I have to move this event probably over to Wisdom Gym where we can hold 500 or 600 or 700 people. Because I think that's where we're headed. And it's so important for you to come back every year. You are the leaders. You're the ones that started the history and have made this university what it is today athletically, as Dr. Hurley has stated more than once today. So it's so important, please come back next year and continue to be a part as we continue to build this athletic department in a direction that you're going to be proud of, in the direction that you want to support, and in the direction that you help build that highway to success. So please continue to come back and be a part of this Hall of Famers. And if someone's not here tonight, please let them know. We have over 300 people here tonight, and it's been a great weekend. And I told you before, we moved the Hall of Fame to a weekend. We used to do it on a football game, but it didn't do it justice. We wanted you to have something special. I hope this has been a special weekend for you because it's meant a lot to Tarleton State University to show us, show our appreciation of what you have. I also want to mention a couple of things before I get off this. Dr. Lamar Johansson is the chair of the Athletic Council. Athletic Council. The Hall of Fame is Athletic Council, too. A chair of the Hall of Fame committee, and then I have other Hall of Fame committee members here. If you all would stand and give them a hand, they have a hard job there every year as putting people in the Hall of Fame. If you're on the Hall of Fame committee, would you please stand? And I know we've introduced our staff tonight, and I really appreciate what the staff has done, but I do want to mention two people, and everybody's had a part of this, and so I'm not going to mention everybody's names. but I have put a couple people on the point of this project, of making this a very successful Hall of Fame. I do not want to take the credit for all of this. I do want to thank Associate Athletic Director Byron Anderson, who's been on the part of this. Byron, please give Byron a hand. He's worked very hard. And assisting Byron has been Kyle Cruz, and they have had so many phone calls from them, you probably know their names and you just want to put a face with it. They have worked extremely hard in bringing this everyone here tonight to have a great time this weekend. So again, it's our honor and it's a privilege to have you back. And let's not make it another 10 or 15 or 20 years before you're here again. We want you here next year. We hope you're at homecoming this fall. We want you to be there. I think we play the University of the Incarnate Word. Is that right, Nate? And if that is October 29th? Oh, that's pretty good. I didn't even know that. Good guess, Ron. So anyways, hey, see you at homecoming. And I'd like to say one more thing. We have the Battle of the Purple in Fort Worth next year. We have the Battle of the Purple. We're getting ready to take on TCU. And let's show TCU who has the best purple. And I want to say this. There's just a few years ago, well, more than that, because I've been here a long time. But if you remember, the last time we played a home game against TCU, and it had to be the men's basketball team, we opened up the season against TCU at TCU. Tarleton prevails. Now, Coach Wigan, it's your turn. Go get them next year. Thank you very much for being here tonight.
Thank you, Coach Reisman. Our next speaker is a member of the Tarleton Hall of Fame class of 2007. He's a professor emeritus in biological sciences and served as chairman of the department, dean of the College of Arts and Sciences, and as the first executive director of Tarleton State University System Center, Central Texas, in Killeen. In 2014, science building in his name. Please welcome Dr. Lamar Johansson.
It is a distinct honor for me to be asked to give a little history of the Hall of Fame pin that you Sunflower Bowl champions are about to receive. I don't know what year it was developed, but a number of years ago by Hugh Wolf. Hugh grew up here in Stephenville. He graduated from Tarleton. He lettered in football and I think track, went on to the University of Texas, and I think I'm correct in this, Hugh was the University of Texas first All-American football player with the New York Giants for a short period of time. Then came home to Stephenville to be in the nursery business with his father. And so Hugh developed this pin that you're about to receive. I think simultaneously, he developed a pin for University of Texas Austin. Now there's a distinct difference between the two pins. Those people at Austin, their pin is a block T with burnt orange enamel. Tarleton's is a block T with purple enamel that says Tarleton Hall of Fame. So that's the difference. Hugh and his wife, Ernie, were great benefactors to this university. They have scholarships. And folks, as far as I'm concerned, one of their major contributions was they donated to the university Ultra. That white arm outside the Clyde Wells Fine Arts Building which is the only thing I know of in the city of Stephenville that points to true north. So, in just a few minutes, you're going to receive the Tarleton Hall of Fame pin. It's not worth much from a monetary standpoint, but you know what? Money cannot buy one. Only way that you can get one is to earn it. And you, the Sunflower Bowl champions of 1986, have earned it. Work, a lot of sweat, dedication, perseverance, teamwork, commitment, loyalty, and so on. We could go on and on with the adjectives to describe what goes into earning this Hall of Fame pin. But in a So you group, Sunflower Bowl champions, you have met the challenge and you have earned the right to be members of Tarleton's Athletics Hall of Fame, and you'll be presented with your block T and plaque and so forth by Dr. Hurley and Coach Reisman.
Since the Athletic Hall of Fame in 1980, 173 inductees have been recognized for their impact on Tarleton State University and the athletic department. No matter the team, sport, or year's play, each Hall of Fame inductee has helped give the Tarleton Athletic Department an identity, not only in the local community, but on the national stage. Every member of the Tarleton Athletic Hall of Fame put our university in the position to make the historic move to NCAA Division I. Tonight, we had a team of student athletes whose talent, perseverance, and drive led them to one of the most historic football seasons in the history of our university. This team joins a prestigious group of student athletes with a mission of bringing to light their accomplishments on the playing field and in life. The 1986 Sunflower Bowl champion Tarleton becomes the 174th member to be immortalized in the Tarleton Athletic Hall of Fame. They are the sixth team of athletes and the third from the storied football program at Tarleton to enter the Athletic Hall of Fame. Described as one of the hardest working, most resilient, and talented group of young men, this group overcame early season adversity to finish the season as one of the best units to ever don the purple and white. The 1986 football season began in darkness as the Texans suffered a 27-12 loss on the road to Oklahoma Panhandle and appeared primed for an 0-2 start to the season as the Texans faced a 21-14 deficit in Stephenville against Howard Payne with 2:24 left in the home opener. As Howard Payne attempted to run down the clock, Jeffrey Edwards recovered a fumble to give Tarleton new life. The Texan offense capitalized with a touchdown from Danny David to Melvin Modest. Snap on the two-point try, David picked it up and crossed the goal line for a 22-21 win that sparked life into the Texan season. The Texans hosted Texas Lutheran for the swing game of the 1986 season, a contest that could keep a postseason berth possible. Lutheran had a chance to take the lead on the final drive of the game, but a 12-yard sack by Rocky Martin on first down and a game-sealing interception from Craig Hancock turned the tide of the season for Tarleton. That win marked the first of what would go on to be seven consecutive wins to end the regular season. Four of those seven wins came by multiple scores, including a 38-22 thumping of McMurray in the annual homecoming game on October 11th, and a 17-point road win over number 11 Austin College the following week. The 8-1-1 Texan football team received the Sunflower Bowl in Winfield, Kansas against Benedictine College in a battle of two of the NAIA's top two ranked teams. Had 26 total yards of offense in the victory, and Bowser rushed for a then school record 210 yards in the season finale. At the time, Bowser was just the second Texan in school history to rush for over 200 yards in a game. The 1986 team set a slew of school records for the time. The team broke the record for single season rushing yards, 2,182. Total offense, 3,521, and most points scored, 237. Ladies and gentlemen, we proudly present the 174th member of the Tarleton Athletic Hall of Fame, the 1986 Sunflower Bowl champion Tarleton Texan football team.
Our next speaker was a starting tight end and team captain for the 86 team that won the Sunflower offense that scored at least 38 points in three of its last six games in a time, as you saw, where up-tempo and spread formation was a foreign language back then. Please welcome Melvin Modesty.
It's an honor and a privilege to speak on behalf of the 86 Sunflower Bowl champions. I waited 36 years for this to happen, and I almost missed the opportunity when I missed the bus. So we're gonna, that's gonna be a story for another time though. Nobody's gonna bring that up, all right? The men that played on this team and in the 80s realized that when we started beating people like Texas Lutheran and West Texas A&M and Howard Payne, they dropped their scholarships, they dropped their programs. Some of them are still not recovering from it. We ended up having to go to Arkansas, to Kansas, to Oklahoma to find people that wanted to compete with us because nobody else wanted to. You couldn't get beat by Tarleton State in the state of Texas and keep your program. So the TIA decided that they couldn't compete with us. So we started all those 8-hour, 10-hour bus trips. And had to find somebody that thought they might have a chance to beat us. When the NAIA didn't let us go to the playoffs that year and put us in the bowl game, the only thing they did was make sure Tarleton didn't win a national championship, because we'd have won one that year because we didn't know how to lose. We didn't do it by ourselves, of course. There was a lot of people involved. Carl Pleasant, Bill Pringle, coaches. They were there in the mornings. They were there at night. They were away from their families to build this family. Coach Mack, Daddy A, they're not with us anymore, but when they came in, those men brought some smart football, and they put the players in position to win games. Susan Burton, before computers, she was taking care of 100-plus football players, making sure we were all lined out and going where we were supposed to. So that without those computers, you can ask her, I don't know if she used paper or pen or what she used, but she figured it out. Switch. Yeah, it's a switch sometimes. Dr. Gillespie and Coach Giles weren't even our coaches, but they stayed on top of us and made sure we were where we were supposed to. More than one time I looked up and one of those red faces was after me and I was in trouble. So Steve Simpson and all his band of trainers kept patching us up and putting us back on the field. Now, before I came up here, David, you mentioned the 85 group that came in. You guys stand up, anybody that came in 85. Now, he didn't have to tell me to mention these guys, because when David Hood, my co-captain, and I were in team meetings with the coaches, they were like, how are y'all going to control these guys? And we said, they can play football, but we can't control them. So we compromised with them. We said, instead of having your parties on Friday night, have them on Thursday night. And on those long bus trips, wait till we're coming back to celebrate. That crew, if you were sitting near one of them, they were trouble. But they could play some football, especially Ivy. Now, my co-captain, David Hood, sitting out here, and he, to me, was always the epitome of Tarleton football. He played offense. He played hurt. He never cried and whined about it. And I almost feel bad about the way our offense punished him in practice every day. Now, a lot of us got a lot of newspaper time, and me and Boo and Danny and all those guys. But the only reason we were able to do that is because we probably had the best offensive line that Tarleton State's ever put together pound for pound. Those six guys with Grayson made it easy for us to look like we knew what we were doing. So anybody that knows football knows it looks good for all of us to get the pub and all the notoriety, but if you don't have a line, the rest of it's a waste of time. So when we went up to the Sunflower Bowl, they had a dinner for us like this, but they made us sit one of their players and one of our players. And it looked like a roller coaster with all their NFL laughing and having a good time. And after the game, we were laughing and having a good time. Dr. Thompson came up to me after the game and he said, what's the matter, Melvin? And I said, you know what? I never get to put this uniform on again. And I never get to play with these men again. He said, don't worry about it. We'll see you in the Hall of Fame. And here we are, guys. Thank you.
Thank you, Melvin. Great job. Our next speaker was a starting cornerback for the 86 team. He led a defense that held opponents to under 26 points six times in 11 games. On a defense that ranks in the top 10 all-time in school history in total points permitted. Please welcome Brad Webb.
Good evening, guys. Boy, what a great honor tonight to get inducted into the Hall of Fame. And probably, I don't know, about 6 months ago, I got a call from Mike Myers on my phone, and it was a call through Messenger. And at first I thought, who is this? It's got to be a scam, because the only Mike Myers I know is the one from Halloween, you know. And needless to say, he called me back, so I said, well, let me answer this. And Mike goes, hey, Brad, just want to let you know that we got inducted to the Hall of Fame. And kind of was just smiling. I drive a lot with my job. I'm a territorial rep, so I was smiling from ear to ear. And also kind of got a little tear in my eye about that, to hear this news. And it's really excited to know that we got inducted to the Hall of Fame and stuff. But we wouldn't have gotten it if we had a great coach. And Coach Pringle, you took a bunch of guys, 86 young men, you and your staff, and you really put us together as a winning team to go out and win the conference and go out and win the Sunflower Bowl. And Coach, I know I speak for everybody. We love you. We appreciate everything you've done. You were a heck of a coach for us on that team. And we thank you for everything you did for you and your staff, which I did. We appreciate it. We love you. Yeah. Now, there's always that saying that defense wins championships. Well, we had a heck of a defense just like we had a heck of an offense. And we had some great players on that defense. You know, like a Robert Ivy and a David Hood. We had Spurlock, James Spurlock. It was excellent. We had a lot of talent on that team. And that's what I remember. I didn't get to really start because Craig Hancock was our free safety, and I played a lot behind him. But I saw a lot from the sidelines when I wasn't in, and seeing the guys out there, you know, fighting and battling and, you know, in the trenches doing what they got to do to win the game. And I looked at some of the scores that we had, you know, the 22-21, you know, that was a close game. When we you know, held Howard Payne to only 21 points. And then we went to Saul Ross, which, you know, everybody knows that's like a 10-hour drive out to Saul Ross. So you go out to Saul Ross and you get beat, it's not a fun drive home. You know, we know that, you know. And for all the staff and players and all that, it's a long haul. But we ended up winning that one 14-6. And defense prevailed in that game. And we just had a great team. And then when it comes to Sunflower Bowl, we went to go play Sunflower Bowl. And like Melvin said, we sat every other guy. And normally with everybody that year with Tarleton, whatever, we could talk eye level. Well, I was having to look up and talk to the guy next to me because he was so big. And every guy was big. And the biggest one was, of course, the starting tailback for Benedictine, Jamie Mueller. The guy was 6'2", 230. Big old boy, big old country boy. He was a tough one to handle, but our defense prevailed and we shut him down. It was just a wonderful team to play on and to play with these guys. It's just a great year. And you know what? I love y'all and thank you. It's just a great honor. Thank you very much, guys.
Our next speaker was enshrined into the Tarleton Athletic Hall of Fame in 2012. He's Tarleton's all-time career and single-season leader in extra points. He's a four-year letter winner. During his time as kicker, he made 54 straight extra points. Please welcome one of the best place kickers in Tarleton history, Mike Myers.
I don't know, can you see me? Last time I was up here, they had to bring in a photo for me. It's wonderful to be here, and it's been a great weekend. and I'm going to speak. A lot of people have already took up what I was going to say, so we're just going to rip that up, and I'm going to be like that dominant left side offensive line and just wing it. And there's an inside joke to that, and I'll let y'all know later. I need to do everything. I would like to let everybody know that we were watching the game this afternoon at the hotel. I got on my iPad, and Robin said, "Why don't you put it on YouTube?" I said, "Well, I don't know how to do that." So Robin has done that, and it will be in the Sunfire Bow face page link. Facebook link, yeah. It'll be in that link tonight. Is that right? I don't know. Where's Robin? Where'd Robin? Robin, it will be in the Facebook link tonight. And so you click on that thing, because we got to make it private, because we don't know the licensing and all that. It's 10 years from now. I'm sure these people are out of business. So, but you know, so it's gonna, we're going to keep it private. So look forward to y'all watching that game. It's a lot of fun. I learned a lot when I was watching this game with this dominating left side line. That's a linebacker, David Hood. And we had quite an afternoon. But anyway, clean the house that up. And then I want to congratulate Carl Present. It's probably, he's being inducted for the third time. And I got to say, that's got to be a record. So let's give him a hand. I want to thank you, Lon, for everything you've done, because, guys, you really don't know the countless hours that went on to do this. I mean, they've been working on this for 6 or 7 months. And just thank you, Lon, and your staff, Terry Hardcastle, Cruz, Anderson. I mean, just thanks so much. Dr. Lamar, thank you for everything you do for this university and everything you've done for this university. And you're a good man, and we love you a lot. Thank you. Now I'm going to pick on Hurley a little bit. You know, I want y'all all to get to know him. He's Dr. Thompson on steroids four times. Four times. And he will always take your call. He might get back to you a little later, but if he wants something, he calls you right back. If I do that. So please reach out to him, get to know him. If there's anything you need, he'll help you. If you got a prospective student that wants to come here, give him a shout. Help if they need help, they'll let us help. So really get to know him. And Kendall, thank you so much for inviting us over to your house. I can't believe you're having all these guys over to your house, because if you'd have known us back in the day, you wouldn't even have thought about it. And Kendall, you know, she classes up Hurley quite a bit. So pretty much like I said, everybody's, but guys, I'm just so excited for y'all to be in the hall. Foundation to where we are at D1. You started it all. That 85 bunch came in. We're all freshmen. We're scared to death. And we had these seasoned veterans take us under their wings and show us the ropes. And we struggled that year because we lost our coach that recruited us all in August. And then Bill Pringle comes in and takes over. And we were really struggling that first year. And then we come back in 86, and we bring in some great acquisitions in Danny David, Boo Jones, and some others. And we still had the veterans players with us. And here we are at Sunflower Bowl, and it starts from there. And look where we've been from there. It all starts from here. When next year we go to the playoffs. The next year we have Tarleton's first undefeated season. And then we're gone, and it kicks us out of the league, and now we've got to go remodel the house and go D2. But have you ever remodeled a house? You never mess with the foundation. You just redo the walls. And that's what they did here at Tarleton. And what happens when you remodel a house? Have you remodeled a house? Your wife's always going to win, and you're going to take the losses. And you're just going to write the check. and we took our licks. But Todd comes back, his third term, back to take us. We should have been in a national championship game that year up in Minnesota. There's no way those guys won 27 plays. That's just bullshit. And we ought to be thankful that Hurley was not our president at the time, or we'd be collecting the hat for his bail money and his attorney fees, because he would have killed those umps. But now we're up to D1, and it all started right here. And it's y'all on the foundation. Now we're remodeling again. But it all started right here. And I want y'all always remember that. And when you wear your Hall of Fame pin, don't ever forget it started with you. And it's something we should be very, very proud of, and I am. And watching that film tonight, I was telling Microbus, I go, you know, it really just hit me. And I, you know, I wasn't getting emotional, but I'm getting very emotional. Because I got in the Hall of Fame on the backs of what you did. You scored touchdowns and put me in the position so I could kick my field goals and my extra points. But you did all the work. And so I thank you from the bottom of my heart, and I welcome you into the Hall of Fame. And I'm going to end my speech with that, but everybody asked me to tell this joke tonight, and I will tell it. So y'all all know I smoke. I've smoked since, and I'm embarrassed, I'm ashamed by it, I'm sorry, but just the way it is. While y'all are getting your ass can't smoke since. When y'all are out there sweating in the heat, I'm taking my shoulder pads off, my top off, I'm suntanning, smoking a cigarette, waiting for special teams to be called. It's a true story. Scott Miss was right with me. He says he was over there training. He wasn't training nothing. So we're going this Sunflower Bowl, and it's going down. It's coming down to it. And you can watch this film, and you will see this happen. So you don't remember how Pringle, you know, Mr. GQ, man, he wore his hat perfectly. He wore his pants up to his belly button. Press shirt, had his headphones on perfectly. And he takes one off and he yells down there at the end, because we're always down there at the 20. He's mine! And I go, what's the hell he want? He must want me to get him a glass of water. I says, yes, sir. He goes, you know, it's probably going to come down to you, and I think you're a little nervous. Go burn one. And I said, I said, are you seriously?
He goes, yeah.
Go.
Go get it out.
I said, all right. So you can see on this tape me crossing over that track. Go get on that bus. Get my cigarette. Go behind the bus. Smoke a cigarette. And you see me coming back. And they got an idea because we made it. Oh, shit. Because Galen Bowser told me, because Benedictine called time out, and Baylor Galen came up to me and he said, listen, you if you miss this kick, I'm going to kill you. I said, man, you don't say that to a kicker. You just leave me alone. Anyway, gentlemen, you always have that plaque. Welcome to the Hall of Fame. And, you know, the plaques, I'm like John Madden. The plaques, the bus talk at the Hall of Fame. I think the plaques talk at the Hall of Fame. And we'll be making a lot of noise tonight. Good talk.
Oh, my goodness. Mike, we want you to do another 5 minutes up here. Come on, we're having too much fun. Let's go. Great job. Oh, my goodness. He had more than a cigarette, I can promise you, Coach. I guarantee you that. Our next speaker is one of only four Tarleton football coaches in the history of the program to lead the team to a conference title with an unblemished record. In three seasons as head coach, he led the Texans to two Texas. championships, and over 20 wins. Please welcome the head coach for the 1986 Sunflower Bowl champions, Coach Bill Pringle.
Marge.
You're fixing to run, boys.
You know what? You know what? You know what? If I'd have known you was doing that, you'd still be walking home. I can't believe all this stuff.
You can't believe everything you hear.
Let me start off with probably the greatest person I've ever known, Harry B. Thompson. And I understand that we have a president now that's a lot like him. If he starts chasing officials across the field, you know he's like Harry B. Thompson. That actually happened. That actually happened. I couldn't believe my eyes. And I'm telling you, he was running hard, and officials were running harder. And I knew then that we better start winning. It was unfortunate that Coach Fox died in 1985 on the golf course. My son, Richard, was playing with that team. That afternoon, I got a call from Dr. T. I really don't know what I was going to say. He called me and he sat down, he looked at me, he said, you want to take this football team? And I said, Coach, I'm going to tell you something, Doc. We only got 2 weeks before two-day start. He said, oh, you can handle that. So anyway, I said, yes, sir, I'll take it. And then just as I got to the door, I turned around and I looked at him. And I said, Doc, do you have any money? He said, I got lots of money. And I knew then he was on the right track. It wasn't the fact that we were going to buy anybody off, but we could pay for a lot of books and stuff like that. And I'd recruited a bunch of guys down south and so on. And we kept looking at this little guy run down the, run from one side to the other. He wasn't very tall. He was chunky looking. Fox, look at this guy. We need to look at him. He said, oh, he's too little. He can't play. And I said, but look at his feet. You don't look at him, look at his feet. He's moving his feet like you're supposed to. That was Rick Orr. Rick Oiler was as tough as any kid I've ever coached. And I see the linemen. I had the offensive linemen. I love those guys. And Rick Oiler, if he found one of them is loafing, you better watch out, because he was going to deck that guy. And that's our own teammates now. But anyway, I love that kid, and I love the way he played. But we had great people. We've had great people, offense and defense. And I hired Coach McAfee. He was an All-American linebacker from Arkansas, and he'd coached for me some before. And he finally decided he would come to Tarleton. And I told him, I said, Mac, I want a full, the five. I said, I've always worked with the five defense. I don't like the 4-2. I don't like that Mike linebacker getting knocked down every time we turn around. Let's get something going. So we got a kid out of Reagan High School named J.P. Rodriguez. And you need to give him a good hand, because when I went down to LBJ to talk to Coach Davis, I told him, I said, I've got some kids coming out of Reagan that are pretty good. And he said, well, I got some, but they're too dumb. They can't do this. And I said, well, I never talked to him about a player like that. But anyway, I had Neely, I had JP, Head Jones kid played quarterback some. And we really got some good kids. I mean, and they listen. And you know what? When you work out in the spring and it's 6 o'clock in the morning and you're working those kids Monday, Wednesday, Fridays, and they're all showing up. And I only had one kid that missed practice twice because I'd locked the doors at 6. And if they weren't there, they were in trouble. So anyway, this kid, I had him come up to my office, and he missed twice. And he got to crying, and I got to crying. And I thought, gee, if this kid loves football as much as I do, and he does, I'm going to keep him. And he wound up a good player, and he is chief of police of the Killeen School District. And I saw him here a while back, and he said, Coach, you know what makes me mad? And I said, what? Any of my teammates or any of my people that are working for me, they better not be late. I mean, hey, neither. So he had turned a lesson. Now, I got to tell you one more. There was a daddy and a little short player that came into my office. And I asked this kid, I said, what's your specialty? Because he wasn't very big and he wasn't very tall either. And I said, extra points and field goals. And I said, well, I happen to be looking for one. I said, let's go out on the field. So I got one of my holders and one of my deep snappers. We went out on the field, put the ball on the 35-yard line, 5 kicks straight down the middle, moved him to the right hash, left hash. Every one of them went through the middle. And I told him, I said, well, I think we can use you, son. And he's that guy that's smoking, I guess, on me. I didn't know about it. But I guarantee you could count on him at 40 yards. He's just like daylight on that stuff. But anyway, we got into the playoffs in 87. And we'd won one game in playoffs. We was just about to whip the other one, but we were having a rough go, and it was fourth down. The only chance we had was to really kick a field goal. You can do it. And he said, okay. And he kicked it right straight down the middle. It hit the crossbar, bounced down instead of up. So that was the end of our season that year. But, you know, I thought then, I told him, I said, I think the good Lord is telling us it's time to hang them up. And if you'd have gone in our field house and seen those 2x4s with the nails on them, you'd have thought, how in the world does he get kids to come and sit in that old field house and suit up and go play a football game? And so it wasn't long until Dr. T came over and he said, Coach, what do we need? And I said, well, let's start with the field house. And we talked for quite a while, and lo and behold, about 3 or 4 days later, 5 Board of Regents from Texas A&M showed up. And they said, I don't know how. He told Dr. T, he said, I can't believe that y'all get the kids you're getting, and this is what they're holding up, putting their clothes on and everything. And I said, yes, sir. Of the stuff that we have today. And I thank Coach Reisman for getting in somebody's ear enough to get facilities like this. Man, oh, man. You know, that's a dream. And Lon, you're to be congratulated for that. And again, Dr. Barry B., I loved him. Thank you, folks. Appreciate you.
Coach Pringle, we want you to be the very first from the 1986 team to receive your Hall of Fame pin and plaque. Congratulations. All right, at this time, we ask all members of the 1986 Tarleton State football team to please line up to the right of the stage, right over here, and you will receive your Hall of Fame pin and flag. If you're a member of the team, please line up.
Take pictures over here.
You do the class.
Yes, I'll do the class.
We're good.
And then they're going to exit over Mars hand.
Okay. So I hit them first.
Yes, sir.
Tell a story.
We'll filler bust for a minute while. While we heard these three-legged cats, but Coach Pringle, it's amazing. As president, I listened to your story and how you asked for more money. Coach Witten did the same thing when we said we're going to go Division One. Do you think you're ready? He said, "Oh yeah, we're ready. The only thing we need is more money." So times haven't changed that much since then
between you football coaches. So.
Ladies and gentlemen, members of the Tarleton State 1986 football team. Allison. Clavando Benson. Galen Bowser. Bukowski.
No, I can't. Thank you very much.
Jamie Childers. Robin Conover O'Brien. Jeffrey Edwards. David Farquhar. DeAndre Gadberry. Brian Garcia. Tarleton Groff. Buff Henderson. David Hensley. David Hood. Henry Holbert. Ivy. Robert Boo. Eric King. Thank you. Thank you, Dr. Joseph. Rodney Lambert. Steve Lawton. Rocky Martin. Bill McCluskey. Kerry Motowell. Melvin Modesty. Tony Montgomery. Mike Myers.
No.
Coach said he has to buy his ring for that story.
Richard Michael Bust. Thank you. Ricky Euler. Richard Proctor. David Ralph.
This is my team, y'all. Thank y'all very much. This team worked a lot.
Jerry Schuster. Steve Simpson. Scott Smith. James Spurlock. Scott Swansea. Chris Tipton. Danny Ward.
Missing that bus would be a good deal.
Thank you, guys. Brad Webb.
Yes. Awesome.
Grayson Wells. David Williams. Ricky Yarborough. Sean Zappalak. J.P. Rodriguez. And Carl Pleasant. Ladies and gentlemen, the 1986 Tarleton State football team, Hall of Fame class of 2022.